An embattled president is dismissing the notion that his administration is in turmoil.
I turn on the TV, open the newspapers, and I see stories of chaos. Chaos. Yet it is the exact opposite. This administration is running like a fine-tuned machine, despite the fact that I can't get my cabinet approved.
But controversy continues to haunt the West Wing.
The whole Russian thing, that's a ruse. That's a ruse. And by the way, it would be great if we could get along with Russia.
The administration still facing scrutiny over its Russian connections. Today, President Trump said he was not aware of any campaign advisors being in touch with Russian intelligence officers during the presidential campaign.
During the election?
No, nobody that I know of.
And insisted he has no personal ties to Moscow.
Speaking for myself, I own nothing in Russia. I have no loans in Russia. I don't have any deals in Russia.
That comes after sources told CNN former top advisors for Trump's presidential campaign were in constant contact with suspected Russian operatives before the president took office. Today, Trump kept up his rosy view of Russia, saying he'd love to have better diplomatic relations.
Nuclear holocaust would be like no other. They're a very powerful nuclear country, and so are we. If we have a good relationship with Russia, believe me, that's a good thing.
That's in spite of recent provocations from Moscow. Russia has buzzed a U.S. warship, placed a spy ship 30 miles off the coast of Connecticut, and deployed a cruise missile in an apparent treaty violation. For now, the White House appears unlikely to respond.
But hopefully I won't have to do anything, but I'm not going to tell you.
In a winding and wild press conference that stretched for over an hour, the president aired a list of grievances.
I inherited a mess. It's a mess. At home and abroad. A mess.
Insisted he would take a compassionate approach to children brought to the U.S. illegally by their parents.
We're going to show great heart. DACA is a very, very difficult subject for me.
And leapt to the defense of his travel ban, which is currently being blocked by the courts.
We had a very smooth rollout of the travel ban, but we had a bad court. I think that circuit is in chaos, and that circuit is frankly in turmoil.
Now, Trump says the administration is crafting a new executive order based on the court's decision.
We can tailor the order to that decision and get just about everything, in some ways more, but we're tailoring it now to the decision.
But while the administration faces pressing priorities, Trump, who once professed his love of WikiLeaks,
this just came out. WikiLeaks! I love WikiLeaks!
Is now preoccupied with cracking down on them.
I've actually called the Justice Department to look into the leaks. Those are criminal leaks.
President Trump spent much of his time criticizing the press.
The press, honestly, is out of control. The level of dishonesty is out of control. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine...
Very fake news. The leaks are absolutely real. The news is fake.
Yet even as he called the media dishonest, the president repeatedly made false claims.
Got 306 Electoral College votes. I guess it was the biggest Electoral College win since Ronald Reagan.
President Obama, 332, yep. And George H.W. Bush, 426. When he won as president. Why should Americans trust you when you accuse the information they receive of being fake when you're providing information?
Well, no, I was given that information.